you like about you, you're about to find out. Rach, this is a tribute for you to let you know how fabulous we all think you are. Enjoy your tributes.
An ode to Rachel Sternberg from the Women's Division.
Rachel, it's hard to believe your time at JUF is coming to an end. You've been a terrific boss, leader, mentor, and friend.
You've inspired our team in so many ways. Your strength motivates us through all 545 campaign days.
You're intelligent and creative, a role model to us all. You've brought the campaign to new levels, never letting anything fall.
We've all been empowered by your wisdom and knowledge, due, of course, to everything you learned from Delta 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 in college.
Rachel, you are funny, witty, and have great taste in TV. I hope one day Serge and Christopher learn the difference between you and me.
Thank you for everything. We will miss you.
Rachel, you've been such a wonderful mentor and teacher to me. You've been my greatest advocate. I owe so much to you, really everything to you as far as JUF is concerned, both in terms of how I think, the way I approach my work, and even where I am. So thank you really from the bottom of my heart. I love you. I'll miss you having you around the office. I know where to find you, so I know we'll be talking more and more. I don't think I could ever replace you, but I will do my best to emulate all of your incredible leadership and the work that you bring and the inspiration. You've certainly inspired me beyond being a mentor, just in terms of standing your ground, going with your gut, being tough, making hard decisions, being accountable, and always looking for a fresh take and a fresh approach. So thank you. I wish you all the luck in the world with anything that you're doing next. You don't need it, because everything you touch turns to gold. We'll see each other soon. Bye, Rachel.
From Rachel, I've learned to take chances. And we've learned that just because you've done something a certain way for a certain amount of years doesn't mean that that's how you should always do it. The idea of the go big or go home is always gonna stay with me. Rachel, you're an entrepreneurial spirit, and that has inspired me, and I know inspired our whole team.
Hi, Rachel. It's been wonderful working with you all these years and accomplishing so much with you, not only for the annual campaign, but the wonderful impact you've had on the centennial campaign and how that's grown also under your influence, leadership, and guidance. And it's been wonderful working with you, and I really enjoyed our Tuesday morning meetings and getting to know you much better, and having a wonderful confidant who shares a lot of the same world views that I do. So thank you again for all you've done for the community, and good luck. And I'm looking forward to working with you on Defiant Requiem. I know that's going to be a tremendous success, and it's going to be a tremendous success because we're lucky enough to have convinced you to keep working with us. So thanks again for everything you've done, and best wishes.
What have we learned from Rachel? The better question is, what have we not learned from Rachel? Rachel has taught us to believe in our abilities, especially as professional women. She's shown us how to command respect from everyone who works alongside her. And Rachel has left big shoes to fill, and we're lucky to have worked with her even for a short period of time. We'll miss you, Rachel.
We will.
Rachel, you have made a huge impact in shaping my development and growth as a professional and manager at JUF. You taught me how to be a leader, how to be a smart manager, how to think strategically, not to overanalyze or get caught up in the minutiae, to go with my gut, and that things aren't always black and white. It has truly been an honor learning from and working with you, and you've been a mentor and role model to me ever since I first met you at the GA in Toronto in 2005, even before I began working at JUF. The day-to-day won't be the same without you, but I'm very excited to continue working with you in a different capacity, and I want to thank you for everything you've done for JUF and will continue to do in the future.
Hi, Rachel. It's Adina. Just wonderful wishes for all good. Wanted you to know that your laughter is contagious and your tears represent an incredible passion for the work we do. Continue being wonderful and the best. Adina.
Hi, Rachel. Here's a couple of things that I love and will definitely miss about you. I'm going to read off of this sheet of paper, so if I'm looking away a little bit, that's just the reason. What do I love about Rachel? One thing that sticks out is any time that we've met about anything, you are already 10 steps ahead and have so many ideas. I have no clue how your brain works that quickly, but it will definitely be missed. Rachel, you've taught me how to be assertive in the missions world and speak up for myself. I've truly enjoyed every minute we've worked together from when I was an intern in 2005 until now. You've always rooted for me and been one of my mentors. I hope that we get that opportunity to travel to Israel together on a mission one day soon. Wishing you all the best. Love, Naomi.
Rachel, as someone who didn't work so closely and directly with you, I don't have many anecdotal stories to share, but I just want to let you know that you truly left a lasting impact on me, and I have always admired you from afar, and not in a creepy way, I promise. But I want to thank you for your leadership, for being an incredible mentor, not just to me, but to so many other women in this organization, and I want to wish you the best of luck and just to let you know how much we're going to miss you. So thank you, and good luck in your next adventure. I know whatever you do, you will be fantastic.
In the 4 short years that I've known Rachel, I've learned a lot about leadership. Rachel has taught me the importance of advocating for my staff and YLD. She has shown me how to effortlessly work with lay leaders, or at least make it look effortless, even though we know there are some real challenges. But most importantly, she has taught me a few tears are okay, because she is a strong and accomplished woman who is comfortable with being herself and something we should all emulate. I feel so blessed to have been taught these leadership skills and qualities by you, Rachel. Thank you.
If there was ever a question of how inspirational Rachel is, after one conversation with her, I moved from LA to Chicago during the polar vortex just to be a part of her team. I don't regret it for a minute, although I will miss working with you. All the best.
Hi, Rachel. For the past 20 years, you've been an incredible colleague and mentor to me. I'm always inspired by your leadership, your vision, your creativity. I feel so lucky to have worked with you for so many years and given me opportunities to learn and grow. And while I'm at it, I also want to thank you for inspiring me to go back to work after having kids. Great decision, and I owe it all to you.
Rachel, when I came to JUF almost 16 years ago to interview for a job, you were the one who interviewed me. And by the time I walked out of that room, I knew that I would take whatever job was offered to me if it gave me the chance to work with you. That was one of the best decisions I ever made. Working with you has been one of the biggest blessings of my professional life, and also, of course, personally, you have been a friend to me like no other. I'm gonna miss you.
Rachel, I feel so lucky to have worked so closely with you over the past several years. The only reason I took the care job was to work for you, and it was the best move I ever made at JUF. It didn't take me long to discover all of your leadership qualities, not the least of which is that you operate with true integrity in all that you do. While I am sad that you are leaving, I feel so lucky to have had the opportunity to work for someone who inspires me, challenges me, supports me, and who I learn from constantly. What I love most about you is that you are human and you're not scared to show that side to others, including your vulnerable moments. Nothing has taught me more in work and in life than to know that you can be vulnerable and not always be perfect, and you can still be the most inspiring leader and mentor, and that's what you've been for me and for so many others. Thank you for being a leader, a teacher, and for all that you have done to ensure a strong Jewish future.
Hi, Rachel. It's Audra. I think you already know how much I'm going to miss you. You have been my thought partner, mentor, and teacher for almost 20 years, and I have learned so much from you, as much outside the office as I have inside the office. And I hope that our lengthy conversations about life, love, and the world continue, and I am going to miss hanging out in your office, and I hope that you come to visit me a lot, and we will keep talking and stay in touch just like it's no different. And I know that you're going to do something important for your mind and your heart, and that you're going to love it and learn and grow, and I look forward to staying on that journey with you. Bye.
When I played folk music long ago, we had an expression: good enough for folk, perfection distracted from the overall experience. We were aiming for a certain feeling, not aiming to make things add up in a mathematical sort of way. But when I started working with you, Rachel, I learned I had to throw close enough for folk out the window. With you, it was about perfection. It was about the math. And boy, oh boy, those numbers better add up. With you, nothing was really ever easy. It was about those numbers adding up, and it was also about the feeling. When it comes to the work of JUF, when it comes to the future of Israel and the Jewish people, when it comes to our community, I know how much you care, feel responsible, and feel connected. I learned from you that when it comes to JUF and all that we do, good enough for folk means it better be the best damn whatever it is that we can muster. It's not always been an easy lesson. It's been a hard lesson in some ways, but it's been a very, very good one too. And for that, I really thank you.
To my most favorite foodie, Rachel Sternberg, a lady I felt like I knew before even meeting you, I come to you live from the Olive Garden on Addison, as happy or happier as you were on the way to Abu Ghosh for our last lunch in Israel after a week of only the finest dining. On that trip, not only did you make sure that I found these glasses that did not leave my face for the duration of the mission when I momentarily lost them at the hotel, you unknowingly turned pierogies into a metaphor, reminding me that choosing anything, especially pierogies, is not merely a choice between mushroom and cheese. The smallest decisions can often have the largest impact. While our time together has only been slightly longer than the amount of time you lost all of your makeup in Poland, my admiration for you will last a lifetime. I look forward to many more occasions where we show up dressed identically, likely in black and white or gray or maybe even beige if we're feeling crazy, making similar expressions on our faces. Thank you for humoring me and experiencing the joy of waking up before the sun rises for spin class, inspiring me to turn up the torque in all aspects of life. I wish you the best of luck in your next chapter and will no doubt continue to text you my feelings in Bitmojis and speak to you almost exclusively in hashtags. May the Dom continue to flow in the campaign halls of JUF to celebrate your legacy for years and years to come.
Rachel, I'm sitting in my kitchen at the limits of my technological ability, trying to record a video that describes some ways that you've inspired me. I have the ways, I just can't seem to record them properly. The story I wanted to tell is really kind of brief. It's just that on four separate occasions, you and I went to talk with a group of people, the Circle of Service Foundation board, a group of Federation executives from smaller communities, and the new professional representing a group called Latino Rising. And on each of those occasions, you had an amazing ability to inspire not only the people we were meeting with, but you inspired me as well. And you did it simply by talking about our work, the collective work of a collective people. You made it clear that all the events, all the effort at fundraising or allocating or grant making, the strategies for programs or whatever else might be going on, all of those flow from this very important ideal. That dissecting it in 100 different ways is also a good exercise and worth people's time, but that the truth remains that JUF is important because Jews are important. You have made that very clear in everything you do. Your passion and your dedication for that shine all the time, really. And I hope that I too can have that in some small measure. Take care and good luck.
Thank you, Rachel, for being such an inspiration. I hope someday I can make half the impact that you've made throughout your career. Enjoy your well-deserved retirement and don't forget about us here at JUF.
Some of the things I've learned from Rachel are how to dim the lights to the exact perfect setting at an event, that you can bounce back from sending out an invitation without a date, and not to blast music in your office when you share a wall with your boss. Truthfully, Rachel, I've learned so much from you, and I'm really going to miss having you around here.
So my favorite thing about Rachel is how incredibly sentimental she is and how easy it is to get her to tear up. This woman is this ferocious, intense professional who's passionate about our cause, dedicated to everything we do, a fierce person who could cry at a Hallmark commercial. I love that about you, and I'll miss working with you.
Hi, Rachel. Your colleagues in L&E want to wish you the best in your new career and tell you how much we've appreciated working with you. You're someone that really understands what we do and inspired us to help you in your work.
And I want to say that I remember when Rachel and I first bonded over the fact that we're both native New Yorkers who've lost our accents, but whose fathers were both high school English teachers. We decided that perhaps we were sisters separated at birth. Really gonna miss you, Rachel.
Hi, Rachel. I owe you a great debt of gratitude. You helped me categorize why a person of this age would still be working. Number one, I love what I do. Number two, I have plenty of vacation time. And number three, most importantly, I have someone to have lunch with every day. Thank you for helping me think that through.
Thanks, Rachel.
היי רייצ'ל, אני מאוד מאוד אוהבת כמה שאת מצחיקה, זה משהו מרגש מאוד ושאת בוכה, אז ממש מרגישים את הדברים שאנחנו עושים כחשובים ומשמעותיים. Oh, you don't understand Hebrew? Oh, so I really, really appreciate your very contagious laughter and when your tears swell, there's a passion for what we do that's really very special and just wish you a ton of good luck. All the best.
So Rachel's leaving JUF. Ho-hum. Anyone who's anyone knows Gina Ercole is the woman behind the woman, the brains behind the entire operation. As long as she stays, JUF will be fine. Sayonara, Sternberg.
Rach, I have searched to the ends of the earth to find the right place to videotape this engine for you, and I found it in Starbucks. It's the only place with wireless that's reliable. Anyway, this is my chance to tell you, you are so phenomenal. It has been such a joy working with you. I have loved it. I've loved getting to know you. You are a pro in every sense of the word. You know what you're doing. You get it done, and that is why we have had such a successful campaign. People love working with you, for you, doing things for you. You just have this great sense and way about you. I'm not sure what will be next for you, but whatever it is, whoever gets to work with you will be incredibly lucky. So good luck, happy trails. We're all gonna miss you, especially me. So, bye.
Sharp day when the heat of a rolling wave can't be turned away. An enchanted moment, and it sees me through. It's enough for this restless warrior just to be with you. And it's enough for this one.